What is going on, you guys? Nick here with another video. Today I am going to show you how to install GrapheneOS from scratch on your Google Pixel. Now you'll notice my launcher here is pretty basic. I actually use Slim Launcher these days just to kind of keep myself under control when I'm using my phone. So anyway, let's just jump right into installing GrapheneOS. So first thing you need to do is get your phone ready to install it. And even though I already have GrapheneOS on this, I'm going to get it again. And we'll just go to About Phone. Scroll down, tap our build number till it says we're a developer. And it says you're now a developer. Yay. All right. So then we can go back out. Go to System. Developer Options. OEM Unlocking, which I actually already had switched on. But we can pretend like I didn't. You just switch it on, and you can turn on USB debugging, say okay, whatever, and go back to the home screen, and that's it. So now we actually need to power off the phone, and the rest of this will be carried out on the PC, with one exception of something that needs done on the phone. So give me one moment, and I'll rejoin you from the computer. So now you can read through all of this, and it's pretty good to go ahead and do that. And we need to get our Android tools for our OS. And your OS is probably Windows. You can do that there. Open that link, download that file, view the file, extract the file, cut the file. You can see I already have the file. And then the very important step here is to open up a terminal and add this to our path. See here, Debian Ubuntu. This way. On Windows, you can do it another way. That other command. And we'll just paste this in. And now that is part of our path. Next thing we need to do is get our phone into bootloader mode. To do that, make sure your phone is disconnected from your computer. Power the phone off. Wait for it to fully power off, and then while holding the volume down key, hold the power button until the phone boots up into bootloader mode. You can then reconnect the phone to your computer or connect to it for the first time, depending on what it is. And you should see device state is locked, assuming that you have a newer Pixel or that you bought your Pixel new. If it's unlocked, don't sweat it. We're going to fix that in a little bit. And we want to make sure that we have the path set properly. So we want to cd out of that ls, and then we want to see that we have platform tools here. Good, so we're not in that directory. And we want to make sure that we have that path. So we'll do that by running fastboot and checking the version. And it may not actually work for me this time because I was one level deeper in that path when I opened this terminal. Yeah, so we actually want to do this again and then check fastboot. Cool, so we can now see that I have access to fastboot from this directory. Awesome. What we want to do next is go ahead and unlock the bootloader. So we just type fastboot flashing unlock. And then on your phone, it's going to pop up and ask you if you want to unlock it. The default option is do not unlock the bootloader. You want to use the volume key to select unlock the bootloader and hit the power key. Your phone will reboot. It'll take just a minute. It'll boot back into fastboot. Cool. So now we want to go to grapheneos.org/releases
You can see all the list. I have a Pixel 5, so I'm going to download the one for the Pixel 5. Now's probably a good time to remind you guys to subscribe to this channel so that it doesn't die. Little channels like mine are getting killed off all the time. Even I shed subscribers, even if they're not actually unsubscribing to me or from me. It's just a thing that YouTube does. So make sure you subscribe and check back periodically. I make videos about Graphene OS, Android phones, Apple phones, chickens, gardens, making concrete pots, pretty much whatever I'm doing, I'll make a video about it. So be sure and check back periodically, because sometimes it's cool, or at least I think it is. All right, so we're gonna view this in the folder. Extract the file. Cut the file. Go back to our working directory. Paste the file. Grab all the files contained within there, cut them out. Paste them back into our working directory. Pop back over to our terminal. Do a quick ls. And we can see all the files. Cool. So now we should be able to .slash flash all.sh, or if you're on Windows, flash all.bat. And we'll see if I get the same error. I got a weird error earlier today when I was trying to make this video, but I know a way around it. So this is interesting. I don't know if this is a bug or something. It says, you're attempting to flash the wrong factory images. This would likely brick your device. Well, this doesn't happen, I can tell you, because I already did it manually earlier. It says, these factory images are for Redfin, and the detected device is Redfin. Well, it's a little odd, don't you think? So what we can do, we can go back to our working directory, can actually look at this flashall.sh. We can see here it says if you fastpose blah, 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 so some checks before it actually goes through the installation process. Then it says products, so we're setting a variable, equals fastboot get variable product. And then it says if this is not true, so if product equals Redfin is not true, then echo, you're attempting to flash the wrong images, echo, and then exit, so it just cancels. Kind of weird. So I have a way around this. You can see we have commands down here. We can pretty much pretend like this doesn't happen, so we can manually flash it, which, as you may have guessed from the title, that's what this is about. You can manually flash these files. Now, this is some pretty low-level stuff. Low-level meaning you're writing files directly to your hardware, not just clicking install from the Google Play Store. So if at this point you don't know what you're doing or you're not comfortable with this, stop, pause the video, close the video, find another channel where somebody explains it better, figure out exactly what you're doing, then come back. What we can do is we can use fastboot here to flash each of these files manually in the order that it's shown to us in this file. So we can say fastboot flash bootloader bootloader-redfin tab complete it and go for it. And it's fine with that, and it worked, and our phone's not bricked. And then our next step is reboot bootloader. Takes almost no time. We're already back in bootloader. And that's pretty much it. You can then proceed on through with each one of these steps here. You can even copy and paste it into your command prompt. Not sure what's going on with GrapheneOS and why this script isn't working right now, but that's the error I'm getting, and this is the easy way around it. And this is how to install GrapheneOS manually, at least on a Pixel 5. Okay, and the last thing you need to do, and I almost forgot to tell you to do this, those of you who are a bit more eagle-eyed may see that I just noticed this as I was editing the video and finished recording a while ago. You need to relock your bootloader. So, let's go fast boot, flashing, lock. Oh, let's get the path set again. One second. All right, paste. And there we go, and we acknowledge this on our phone just like we did when we unlocked the bootloader. Phone reboots again to bootloader, and at this point you can tell it to just go ahead and boot when it comes back up. Thanks for watching. Again, please subscribe to the channel. Leave a comment down below. If you liked it, like it. Use the Amazon links in my other videos to support the channel. Whatever you want to do. Or dislike if you disliked it, even though apparently that doesn't matter anymore. Thanks again for watching. See you in the next video.